Hello and welcome to Tips and Tricks from Davao Ship Modeler. Davao Ship Modeler is specialized in fine handcrafted ship models and custom builds. You can find us on Facebook at Handcrafted Wooden Historic Ship Models. If we are talking about model making, we may have to separate beginners and professionals. In these Tips and Tricks videos, we will give you some professional tips and practical applications. This video will be about realistic deck planking on model ships. If we are planking the deck of our model ship, we have to decide how much effort we want to put in this part of the build. Because deck planking can consume a large amount of time, depending on how much detail we want to apply. Let us see first what different deck planking designs we know. First, there will be the brick design, and I'm sure that even beginners know this design, because it's the most common design in commercial model kits. The advantage of this design is it's easy to install, and it will give us a nice and clean finish. Next, there will be the 3 and the 4 butt shifting system. As you can see in the picture, it's still a simple arrangement. It's widely used from the more advanced modelers and consume a little bit more time in the preparation of your deck. This design will give you a more realistic look of your deck. Depends on what ship you are building. Coming to the point to give our deck a more realistic look. Because of the large amount of methods, it's impossible for me to show you all kinds of techniques. So I will reduce this video to the most common techniques, what will be used to imitate the sealing or also called corking, and also weathering and aging the wood. The most common method to imitate the corking used by modelers is to darken the edges of each plank with a pencil or permanent marker. After arranging the planks on your deck, it will give you the impression that the complete deck is sealed with tar or synthetic sealants. I personally prefer oil pastels or pencil to darken the edges. Depends if I want to give the deck a new or weathered look. If you want to give your deck a new, clean look, paint all edges of each plank with a hard pencil and arrange the planks on your deck in the design you desire. Then make your nail marks, also with a hard pencil. After the glue has hardened, sand your deck first with an 80 grit sandpaper, then finish it with a 360 grit. Remove all the dust and seal it with a matte varnish. If you like to give your deck a slightly loose impression, I can give you a personal tip. Darken all edges of each plank with a black oil pastel and arrange the planks on your deck. After the glue is set, wipe off the excess oil pastel with a paint thinner. That will leave some of the oil pastel in the deeper regions of each plank. After the deck is dry, sand your deck with an 80 grit sandpaper and finish it with a 360 grit. Remove all the dust and seal it with a matte varnish. In my case, I do not mark the nails with a pencil, because in reality, all nail holes are covered with a wooden plaque to seal them off. So I drill all nail marks with a 0.5 mm drill bit, depend on the scale, and seal it with a wooden plaque from a different color. Sometimes you see modelers using toothpicks to plug these holes, but that only works if your planks has a different color than your toothpicks. Coming already to the last tip in this video. If you want to give your deck a dark weathered look, let your pre-cut deck planks soak for one day in a bowl with vinegar and a piece of steel wool. When the planks are still wet, darken all edges of each plank with a black oil pastel and glue them on your deck. After the glue is set, slightly sand your planks with an 80 grit sandpaper. Then let them dry thoroughly and finish them with a 360 grit. Remove all the dust and seal it with a matte varnish. Again, for the nail marks, I use wood plaques. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please make sure to subscribe to this channel. That way you got immediate update for our new videos that we are going to post every week.